anyone that's been to Chengdu for an extended period of time, and they'll tell you. The underground music scene here is something special, something different. We wanted to find out what exactly it is that makes this place so unique. To do that, we spoke to a wide range of people, both veterans and newcomers who were deeply involved in the music scene here.
I'm Marcus.
I'm Bill Na.
Philip.
Guangde.
Yang Bing.
Wu.
Shane.
Shen Yue.
Hong.
Igor.
Heinz Martin.
Charlie.
Luna. Evan.
Bashir.
Tuan. I'm from Amsterdam, Holland.
United States.
Croatia.
Morocco.
Holland.
Beijing.
Beijing.
Chengdu. I'm a local.
Chengdu.
From South Africa.
Swiss.
Estonia.
I'm from Germany.
St. Petersburg, Russia.
First, we asked people what makes Chengdu itself such a special city.
Chengdu is like a dark horse in China. Everybody looks at Hong Kong, Shanghai, and Beijing in China, and people don't really know anything beyond that.
Chengdu is one of the most coolest places that I've seen, where there's a lot of diversity.
It's very different, it's more peaceful, it's more relaxed. That's what you hear all the time, but it's really true.
Chengdu is not a village. You know, it's a big city, it's 14 million population. So there's a big audience for doing cool stuff here.
First, I think Chengdu people are really different in China. Chengdu people, they like to try new things.
Musicians, artists really find similar souls, so they can connect and create something bigger.
It's very artistic.
It's a little bit more open, it's more a gay city, it's more a liberal city, I think. There's a lot of creativity, art, music. That's really nice.
Really brings people here to enjoy the vibe.
The vibe in Chengdu, it's very chill, but also kind of hot.
The vibe was really fantastic.
Chengdu is like this, man, you know what I mean? It's cool.
Music scene is top notch. That's special.
I think that Chengdu is more genuine in the fact that people do it because they really love what they're doing.
People here, love to have fun.
There's the only special people from the whole world. We came together and they create something new.
Oh, everybody that comes here says that we party like crazy, so I guess we do something better.
Like most things in China, the music scene here has really developed over the last few years. We went to several local venues to check out how things have changed recently.
You want the short story or the long story?
That's a simple question with a big answer.
The scene has really developed exponentially.
I went to Shanghai, Beijing, I studied in Canada before. I went to party, rain. But when I'm back home, there's nothing going on.
And when I first came to the city, there was only one foreign bar in the city.
The music scene in Chengdu was for a long time very underground, so what I mean is like it was growing very slowly.
After the earthquake in 2008, a lot of people stopped going out. You know, the party scene had changed a lot.
I do the techno music, especially electronic music, 20 years already. Yeah, long time. But now I think changing a lot, more and more people join.
At first it was a small community. It was very personal. People knew each other. Actually, everybody kind of knew each other.
And something happened 3 years ago.
Nowadays, like 3 years later, it's grown so much.
All of a sudden, I was surrounded by organizers, initiators, brains, artistic people. Everybody wanted to do something.
It's gone from like really small venues into a plethora of venues, many of which are in this building which we're standing in right now, the Poly Center. So this place is infamous all around China for having a dozen or more venues in one building, which is fairly unprecedented for anywhere in the world, I mean, let alone China.
It's impossible to discuss the underground scene in Chengdu without talking about the Poly Center. By day, a seemingly mundane apartment building. By night, however, it becomes the heartbeat of the underground scene.
And I came just as tag, and here we go, we're opening, right? So I kind of missed the old part of the scene.
我知道成都现在有一个 Poly， 对，在 Poly 里面有很多很多俱乐部。你在一栋楼里，你可以去这儿，你可以去那儿，你可以去那儿。And
now we're like I said, an epic moment. You can go out in the night in the city, and you can go to like different clubs and different bars, and have different genres of music all in one night.
Poly is also one of the best places to see how Chinese people are becoming more involved in the underground scene.
The party people start changing.
It's younger generation starting to feel more energy from the music.
You know, they really know what's really fun, real fun, or what's not.
These Chinese, new Chinese hipster, they're bored with the show. They're bored by KTVs. I don't know what to call the style. It's not hip, it's not hip-hop, it's not techno.
I think the underground scene in Chengdu became better and better because it got more substance to it.
There's three main venues in Poly Center that showcase different sides of the underground scene. Here We Go, NASA, and TAG.
In the city, probably Here We Go Club. I think they have done a great job.
Definitely Here We Go.
Chinese people and foreigner people to work together, it's not easy, but it's also, but it's really cool.
Like, I really respect DJ Wu a lot. Wu is the owner of Here We Go Bar.
DJ Wu and I actually threw a really cool hip-hop event many, many moons ago.
It's really for getting more and more different kinds of music to Chinese.
Here We Go is on the top floor of the Poly Center, and is known for being open and unpredictable in the kinds of music it plays. Down two floors is NASA, which focuses more on styles like hip-hop and trap.
NASA is amazing, NASA's great, I love NASA. Arsan, Ravi, all those guys, man, I knew them like ages ago.
NASA has begun to cater to a more Chinese crowd, but is still regarded by both foreigners and Chinese alike to be one of the best venues in the city. Back on the top floor, just down the hall from Here We Go is TAG, Chengdu's techno headquarters.
I've worked on several projects. One of them was a nightclub called TAG, To Another Galaxy.
That one has done a lot, starting from establishing the club TAG, which has now become one of the most famous house techno clubs in China.
The club TAG.
TAG.
Yeah. The best techno club in the whole country.
Me and my friends, so many people who love electro music, they feel a little bit boring to do. That's why we opened TAG. Very interesting thing is like if we invite our international DJ come from Europe or America, dance floor, maybe 80% Chinese, just 20% foreigner.
In the beginning, in the first weeks, months, we really had to like pull them to the dance floor. We had to really like literally pull people to the dance floor. And if you go right now and see, it's not necessary anymore. People just dance by themselves. They understand the concept.
In Beijing or Shanghai, it's different. We have more local people. They love music.
At Chengdu, you can feel the people dancing crazy. They're just into this music.
It's definitely all new, but it's growing. It's still growing and year by year.
Once they see this for the first time, they see all these people, they're like, oh my god, this is much cooler than just sitting, drinking and playing some games.
Right now, Chinese people are more curious about, okay, what's the motivation behind it? What's the culture behind it?
For me, it's the best city.
What I want to see in Chengdu, since it's accelerating so fast, I want to see this bringing the whole Chinese scene a little bit further and make it a little bit more pure.
It will continue to grow like this. There will be more venues, more promoters. You see more people from Shanghai moving to Chengdu, from Beijing moving to Chengdu. That's really interesting. Before, people were moving from here to big cities, but now you see the other way around. And that's like, yeah, that the future is good.
There's multiple other underground venues in Chengdu that we could discuss, but we also wanted to offer a glimpse into some different areas of the music scene. To do that, we went to Strawberry, a music festival that's held in many cities around China and offers a unique mix of Chinese rock and electronic music.
It's a great way to introduce electronic music to people that are actually have no knowledge of what it is and what it can be.
Yeah,
I think Strawberry is, you know, you can see so now the a lot of people here are really good for the city.
我已经连续两年、三年一直在跟着草莓一块走，然后我觉得炮做得非常好。
I'm the director of electronic music for Modern Sky. I started working with them about 2.5 years ago. A Strawberry Festival, Beijing and Shanghai had a stage, but that was it. We started to expand to Shenzhen and Guangzhou, and eventually also to Chengdu.
You can see the Strawberry, so now the like 5,000 people on the dance floor, crazy, you know. 10 years before, we didn't think about 10 years later, so 5,000 people.
Chengdu actually is on top of my list because, yeah, what I just said, man, it's like there are a lot of cool people doing cool stuff here.
Finally, we asked all the people we interviewed to talk about their favorite underground event in Chengdu. The vast majority of them had the same answer.
Man, the coolest party doesn't exist anymore.
What is that?
Dojo, definitely. Dojo house party for sure.
Dojo is an American-style underground house party, which is located on the outskirts of Chengdu.
American movie style house party, but in a house that's nobody's, so there's nothing to break.
I love Dojo, and it's my favorite place to play.
I have to say, it's a Dojo party.
It's definitely Dojo.
It's Dojo.
I miss Dojo, of course.
I mean, it was based on an American house party, which I went to in Quantico, Virginia. And they were epic. They were like 400 person house parties in the middle of nowhere. And I wanted to recreate that in China. It wasn't just me, obviously, it was a group of people, but that was the idea. That's kind of the best way to describe it.
I've been there 2 times, and it was so sick.
Working at Dojo, the thing was, it was more about a team spirit, it was non-commercial, and a really good atmosphere. It was fun.
As a DJ, you feel like you can play whatever music you want. And the people who go there actually get that music.
You're shoulder to shoulder with everybody. There's a real feeling of equality. It's not a club. There's no reserved tables. There's no elevated DJ booth. It's this real feeling of like everybody on the same level, this kind of common, personable feeling.
It's complete freedom. Crowd digs everything.
It was like freedom. Just the many people, the crazy place, far from city. A lot of fun.
At Dojo, we kind of did our own thing. Everybody could play the music that they like.
Music, like first time I went to Dojo, it was different music that I would like to listen to. And then I go after 1 hour, I listen to one of my favorite tracks from a producer, Jordan Peak, and I'm like, okay, now it's, I understand, it was for everybody. That was the Dojo. It was a party for everyone.
The whole idea was to be unpredictable, you know, to do something different every time. It was not a business. It was not made to make money. It was a free event. The whole idea was just to have fun.
Sadly, the final dojo party took place in 2015.
It was kind of a confluence of factors which led to an ending. I mean, one was the house is actually getting bulldozed. So, I mean, it really can't go on forever, I mean, regardless. But I feel like bigger than that, we had done it for 3 years, and everyone had had such an amazing time. We had achieved all of our goals. BBC came into Dojo, filmed it, had a great time. I mean, people from India came to Dojo, people from Russia came to Dojo. I mean, we just achieved everything we wanted to achieve. And at that point, there's just kind of nowhere else to go. I mean, really, one of the biggest hopes when we stopped doing Dojo was that someone else would pick it up, you know, that someone else would be inspired by this or influenced by this, and that they would do another underground event.
Harry Beardman is awesome. Harry Beardman is awesome.
The volume levels were good.